Hello, everybody. This is MAXRDARX, also known as Mordoz, within the community of gaming places, things. And this is the Night of the Rabbit. Hopefully, this will be really awesome, because I've seen so many freaking awesome reviews on it. And, it seems to be a hell of a lot better, just from the little bit I have played, to preview it a little bit, to see if it's even worthy of any kind of playthrough. And it does appear to be quite awesome so far. This is made by the same people who made Deponia and Deponia 2. I wasn't too thrilled with Deponia. I may or may not do a review on that later. But let's just get into it, because it is quite a long beginning. Around 15 minutes or so of getting through it to the actual gameplay. So maybe 12, 10, if you're careful. Can't skip. You can skip things, but I don't want to skip anything for you guys, you know? Because, you know, I don't want you to miss anything. Alright, let's get to it. Start new game. Yes. Here we go.
And so it begins. My apprentice's finest hour. If only I had been there, I could have prevented it all.
So that was the prelude, I guess, prelude. And we're inside of something. It looks like some kind of vortex, or not a vortex, but a inside something. Like the roots going down, or dirt path, can't quite tell which. It looks very plant-like, so I guess kind of like a tree portal, so I don't know. Let's talk to this dude. This odd figure. It looks odd. It's like a statue.
Oh, who are you? Can you not speak? Does that mean you don't know? Are you lost?
Am I lost? Yes, because I would like you guys to see what happens. No, it'll just get me to the portal area. Spoiler alert, in a few seconds, minute or so, it's gonna be right here. It'll just pop me over there. That's okay. I want you guys to see it.
Oh, so you're looking for the beginning of your story. If we can find you a beginning, you'll know where to go from there. You have no idea how lucky you were to cross my path. I know a lot about stories. I hope you aren't just here to steal one of mine. You aren't, are you? All right. To find your beginning, we must look for something that feels like once upon a time. Follow me.
Okay, dude. I shall follow you. Because you seem to know what you're doing. Well, I am merely lost. Lost little bunny rabbit.
There you are. Now we just have to find your beginning. Even if you lose yourself, beginnings can be found anywhere. And only those who start can find their way. And you will recognize it. A beginning smells like the air in spring and the hope for more. A beginning is... I think you already know. Endings, on the other hand, well, we can worry about those later. Do you understand?
He's not entirely... He's kind of cryptic there. Beginning is very subjective to people. But he's relating this to stories. So in that sense, yes, I understand how, where he's coming from there. It's clearly not about reality. So let's move on.
Really? It's been a long time since I've met someone with such a keen intellect. Did you hear something? The fog must be playing tricks on my imagination. It's gotten cold, don't you think? Follow me.
Yeah, this guy's going crazy. I didn't just see that lizard laughing manically and leaving like that. I didn't see that at all. This guy must be nutso. Nutso. Okay. Okay, we'll talk to him again. There it is.
There's your beginning. It's really lucky you stumbled upon me. I don't think you would have found your beginning all by yourself. You look familiar somehow.
I just have that face.
I'm sure we shall meet again, unless the fog thickens more. I can't see the hand in front of my face already.
We'll ignore the fact that he wasn't.
He reminds me of a character in one of my old tales.
Interrupting me.
I hope he finds his way. Not even I could say where he'll end up if he doesn't, or when.
Yes.
So, let's help his beginning along a bit. Ah, this beginning rhymes. I must note it down right away.
Indeed, yes. Alright, so we begin. And I don't know if we control that rabbit anymore. There we go, this is the...
After a long summer day, in a place not far away, Jeremiah Hazelnut was tucked in bed to dream of the dream that he always had. Each night to his mother, Jerry did say,
I want to be a magician one day.
And each night she would reply, as mothers do,
one day, sweet son, your dream will come true.
And as mothers do, she whispers,
good night.
Soon Jeremiah Hazelnut would sleep tight. And soon, very soon, as dreams sometimes do, the dream that he had would come true.
There we go. The true intro to The Night of the Rabbit. Pretty freaking sweet, huh? Now, we're about 9 minutes in. So that was just all 9 minutes, including what I was talking in the beginning. It's about maybe 5 minutes. Not too bad. Now this part is going to be a mini tutorial on how to move around and stuff. Teeny tiny spoiler.
Jerry! Yeah? What do you want,
Wake up, sleepyhead!
Oh no! Am I going to be late for school?
Come outside and enjoy the sunshine! You don't want to sleep away your whole summer vacation, do you?
Summer vacation?
Jerry, school starts the day after tomorrow. You don't have to worry about your things until then.
I still have 2 days before school starts.
I've still 2 whole days of adventure left. Ha ha!
Like we do every day with our morning calisthenics. It's our program. Start the day fit and cheerful.
What on earth is this? Usually it's the top 40 playing all day long.
The crows must have overdone it yesterday. There's not a single one in the sky this morning. What a beautiful day.
Crows?
But don't just sit there and rust, or you'll just make it easier for them tomorrow. Okay, follow my lead. If you don't want to listen to our program, then go ahead and start your day any way you like. Imagine a small X floating in the air. You can click on it to drop out anytime.
Wow, when he says it like that, I can practically see the X floating in front of me.
But why would you want to drop out? What? You think you already know everything? Smart Alec. Touch the radio. Imagine a mouse pointer. Move it to the radio and click with the left mouse button.
Okay, at this point, I could skip this. Because this little bit... not much. It's a little bit just to how to move around for point-and-click games. I don't really need this as a seasoned veteran in the point-and-click game. But it's interesting how they implement this into the game. It's very seamlessly. However, it kind of breaks the fourth wall slightly by introducing...
Come on, you can do it.
Oh.
Touch the radio!
I didn't know it would do that if I wait too long.
Follow my lead.
Yes, sirree.
Anyone can do it.
Okay, quit being annoying.
Imagine a mouse button.
We're doing it already.
Move it to the radio and click with the left mouse button. Good job! Well done!
Child's play.
You can tackle anything just like that. Looking, talking, using, running around. Just click on it. One click. Everything is just one click.
Yeah, yeah. Is this a sales presentation or what?
Now, let's try it again. This time, talk to the radio. Yes, that thing where the voice comes from.
Talk to the radio?
Once again, just click on it.
You mad man? Why would I talk to the radios? There's a receiver on here, obviously, so that's not too far-fetched. Hello? That's too boring. I'd like to say hi to my mother.
I'd like to say hi to my mother?
Young Mr. Hazelnut would like to say hi to his mother. You did very well.
Thanks. But how?
One click. Everything is just one click. Did you notice how your muscles and sinews stretch when you click on something? Doesn't that feel good?
He's right. I ought to do morning calisthenics more often.
You're probably thinking, I ought to do morning calisthenics more often.
Man, he's good.
And you know what?
What?
You can. It's our program. Start the day fit and cheerful. And on we go. Some things can be looked at and picked up. That's good for the back. So, keep looking at things and picking them up. Now find yourself an object to look at.
How about that basket on the windowsill?
You already found something to pick up? Go ahead then.
Okay. It's the only thing I can pick up.
That's the way. That's good for the back. You are now carrying the basket. You open the inventory by scrolling down with the mouse wheel, or by pressing the I key.
Man, oh man.
Now, let's try it again. Have a peek in your inventory.
Okay. Scroll wheel.
Doesn't that feel good? Your inventory.
Oh, yeah.
You can carry a lot
feels
more around
real
here than
good,
you think.
Man.
And carrying objects around is healthy. You can also look at them. To do that, click on them with the right mouse button.
I'm not quite convinced it would be healthy to carry stuff around. Depends on the weight, I guess.
No, use the right mouse button to look at the button. Using the left mouse button too soon can lead to serious injury.
Oh my
we'll
god.
We'll get to the left mouse button.
Ah, nice basket. Hey, looking with the right mouse button works really well.
Looking with the right mouse button works really well, doesn't it?
Absolutely.
And now we'll try the left mouse button. Use the left mouse button to take a left click on the basket.
Yeah, I'm skipping a little bit.
Oops.
Ah,
The handle fell off.
That isn't supposed to happen.
Normally, you just pick the basket back up.
But don't panic. Remember, there are no problems, only challenges. You're bound to repair that basket in no time, for sure.
Use the left mouse button to select items in your inventory. That will allow you to use them with other items in your inventory. Use one of the items with another one. That will get your circulation going.
That's kind of a clever way of introducing combining items. Okay, let's try this. Boom.
There! That wasn't so hard.
True. It was easy.
And do you notice how your pulse is calming? Feels good to repair something you broke, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does.
And now for the next step. You can also use items with your environment. Left-click on the basket, and then carry it out of your inventory by moving it past the inventory's edge, or by pressing the I key, or scroll up with the mouse wheel.
Yeah, okay.
Boom. That's not what we were going to do now. Hope you didn't pull a muscle. Just open your inventory again. Left-click on the basket, and then carry it out of your inventory by moving it past the inventory's edge. Very good. Try showing the basket to a beloved family member.
Who should I show the basket to?
I think your mother is hanging up the laundry in the meadow in front of the house.
Man, he's good. Wow.
I said that.
It's as if he's talking to me.
Use your basket with your mother by moving the basket to her and clicking the left mouse button.
This is much fun. Who else would I show it to? Come on now.
Oh, Jerry, as you've got the basket...
Yeah, and I didn't break it at all.
That's fantastic! Could you go and pick some blackberries for me?
For blackberry pie?
Of course!
Oh, boy. Pick blackberries, check.
Congratulations! You've completed your fitness program for the day. And remember, a simple leg cramp could cost you your life when you're fleeing from a wild crow.
Huh? What's he talking about?
Stay fit, stay cheerful. Mousewood Radio now continues with the Leaffall Report.
Mousewood Radio? Never heard of that. It must have something to do with sunspots.
That's me slapping my thigh because that was really funny. Anybody get that reference? Make sure to comment below, please. Because that is a reference not to be missed. Now, keep in mind, and I hope I'm not repeating myself, I only know about all this stuff because I've been trying to get this thing to work, for some reason. I've used Camtasia, and it's been really difficult for me to get everything, all the settings and everything working correctly. For the first time, I had a black screen, and you could hear everything very badly. Second time around, screen, but stuttering, and the audio was sucky. Third time around, got the video part perfect, but the audio sucked, so I had to change codecs, blah blah blah, and now it finally works. But the fourth time I worked on this, tried to do it, I did it with all the correct settings and everything, but Camp Vista crashed and tried to save it, but it saved it as some other episode that it had in its whatever, and it wasn't even this, it was Minecraft. So... is my Finding Way Home series I was trying to start. So I don't get that. Crazy Ken Vista. Camtasia, whatever. So, not a big deal. Here we go. Let's look at the well-camouflaged suit death. Let's look at the mail first. Check out all this out.
I think Mum already picked up the mail.
Indeed she did. I'm hungry.
I'll take one for later. That's supposed to be good for your eyes, and an adventurer like me needs to see everything.
That's true.
Strange. Footprints. A large animal must have run through the carrots under my window last night. I'd say it was a mysterious, long-extinct mammal. The gremlin boy. Ever since I became a junior member of the Jungle Explorers Club, my theories have sounded a lot more convincing. So much expertise for just 50 cents a month.
Oh, gullible kid. But, you know, that's how many of us were back then. When I was about, what, 10, 8, 8 or so, I believe in fairies. But that turned out to be a very strong imagination, and fireflies, and bugs, and whatnot. There's actually a migrating pattern of various different insects that I thought were, you know, were fairies or something, so I would just sit there, awestruck. But honestly, it's not about the actual reality of the thing, more of the feeling you get, of the amazement. That is a priceless thing you get as a kid. It kind of goes away when you get a little bit cynical about the world, like I have as I get older. Okay, enough depressing stuff. Look at this thing.
We call that old rock the dwarf. Mom says it's been living here since long before we came. Please keep watching out for us, old dwarf. Sweet and juicy.
Jerry!
I'm okay, Mom. I won't need them all.
What? Jerry, I just want to remind you to pack your things for school tomorrow.
Yeah, I'll do it. School.
That's the discrepancy I noticed. It may not have been intentional. I don't know. In the beginning, she said, oh, he has 2 days free to do space. Excuse me, words. 2 days free to spend his summer vacation. Yet just now, you have to pack for tomorrow. What? For school tomorrow? Maybe the wording I'm not quite understanding or something, but I thought he had 2 days, not 1 day. And as you'll see later, he will say again 2 days. So I guess we're sticking with 2 days. Let's try this.
Empty. I think Mom already picked up the mail.
Yeah. Okay, secret stash. Well, camouflage here.